So our next area is past adjustment. Some of you have doubt that what happens if an accountant makes a mistake while preparing profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, as you make mistake in exams, the accountant can also make some mistake in profit while preparing the accounts. But this mistake can be rectified by using a past adjustment account and by making a single adjustment entry. Okay, so without correcting the whole financial statement, this mistake can be corrected by the accountant. Okay, and to correct that, an account is being prepared, and such account is known as past adjustment account, and such entry is known as past adjustment entry. Okay, so the mistakes can be like first one, an omission of an appropriation item. Appropriation item means interest on capital, salary, interest on drawings, commission, etc. If we omitted one item to be recorded in the profit and loss appropriation account, okay, what we can do to correct it? Okay, the second mistake can be wrongly sharing of profit. Suppose we do not have partnership deed. Okay, and we share the profit in 3:2:2. But as you all know, in the absence of partnership deed, the profit is to be shared among the partners in 1:1:1. That is equally. And we wrongly shared the profit in ratio 3:2:1. So what can the accountant do to correct it? We can make profit and loss of that past adjustment account to correct it, to rectify it. Okay, and third case is that both this occurs, and omission of an item and wrongly sharing of profit can also occur. Two mistakes can occur. Okay, and these are the three cases where the mistake can be committed by the accountant. Okay, and we are now going to study how the accountant can rectify if one of the appropriation item is omitted. That is, suppose one of the item is omitted while preparing profit and loss appropriation account. We are taking an example. A, B, and C are the partners sharing profit and loss in the ratio 3:2:1. They have partnership deed. Okay, and we have shared profits. The partner shared profit in this ratio 3:2:1. But after preparing profit and loss appropriation capital account balance sheet, and after that we have seen one omission, one mistake. Okay, what was that mistake? Interest on capital in the partnership deed was at 6% per annum, but the accountant forgot to debit that in profit and loss appropriation account. The accountant omitted that. That means the expense was not accounted in the profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, so interest on capital at 6% was not allowed to the partners. It was not given to the partners, or it has been not credited to partners, or it is not debited in the profit and loss appropriation account. So what can the accountant do? It is much easy. Please listen. So we have to calculate interest on capital that has to be paid to the partners. That is, A's capital was 3 lakh. So A is to get interest on capital 6% per annum. That is 3 lakh into 6% is 18,000. B is to get 2 lakh into 6% is 12,000, and C to get 12,000. Okay, so the total interest on capital is 42,000. That is, this 42,000 is an expense for the business. That means they are paying it to the partners, so it is an expense for the business. So this expense was not recorded in the profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, so we have to record this expense. Okay, so for that we have to prepare one account, that is past adjustment account. Okay, so past adjustment account means we have to prepare one particular column, and three columns for three partners. According to the number of partners, we have to prepare the number of columns. Okay, so there are three partners A, B, and C. So we have to prepare three columns for A, B, and C, and one final column for the firm. That is, we have to make one column for firm also. Okay, for each partners, we have to make one debit and credit column. Okay, so A's column is divided into two. That is debit and credit, and similarly B, C, and firm debit and credit. Okay. Now we have to record the item we have omitted. We have to record the item we have omitted in past adjustment account. That is, we have to write interest on capital. Okay. So what is the amount that has to be paid to A? 18,000. Okay. This 18,000 should be received by A. That means A is to get that. When A to get that, A should be credited. Okay. When A to receive that, A should be credited. His capital increases. So this 18,000 should be credited to A. Okay. And B's interest on capital is 12,000. So it should be credited to B. And C's interest on capital is 12,000. So it should be also credited to C's capital account. And for firm, these all are expenses. So it should be debited to firm's account. Since these are income for the partners, it is credited to their partner's account. Okay. Now, when in the point of view of business, it is an expense. So it should be debited. So the total interest on capital, that is 42,000. Should be debited in the firm's account. Okay, so this is the only item we have omitted. So we have to balance this. Okay.